All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome to tonight's stream. Going to be doing some Iron Banner tonight. Very exciting stuff. But I'm also going to be recording a podcast with the Rectified Gaming guys. So we're going to put my multitasking skills to the test here. I'm not sure how it'll turn out, but we shall see. So let's see. So I've been playing Destiny since the very beginning, and this is the first time I'll be doing any Iron Banner stuff. I know it's very shocking.
Hey, shit's on you. Okay. Alright, so let me get this back up. Okay. Twisted.
Yep.
I'm ready. Is everyone ready?
Yeah, extra either.
Yeah, I'm good.
Cool. Alright, tell me when you're on. Then.
Alright.
Alright, you got on?
Okay. We're good. I'm good.
Okay. Cool. Okay, that's what I wanted to know.
You are listening to episode 37 of the Rectify Gaming Podcast. I'm your host, Twisted Shots TV. Good afternoon. Good evening. You like that? I'm checking in tonight to see what some guys are up to and see if they're playing video games. We're going to talk about tonight. And before we jump into who our guests are this evening with us, I am being joined, as always, by the man, the myth, the legend, Ty Boy and 17 in the house.
Hey, what's up? Long time no see once again.
We've kind of we've slipped off the typical radar. I know it's kind of the post summertime when you get past the game, yeah. You know,
PAX, all the convention tours.
It's been crazy.
Yeah.
It'll be good to.
Their glory goes to you, Guardian.
And, sometimes we're a little bit more regimented and planned. And, so tonight we're actually doing this podcast live over on our Twitch channel. And if you're not currently on there, you need to do so, because we do these every so often. And you can actually put some input in too. I think iBoy and a couple other guys will be watching the stream and seeing if your comments might pop up. And, you never know, might end up being in part of one of our podcasts, so just a little thing out there to throw it out there. Title, you can just get started at this twitch.tv/rectifygaming.
Yes, it is, sir. Straight up. No underscore, no nothing. It's Rectify Gaming.
No, they don't have tags. No.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get to our guest tonight. Somebody that you have heard on the show, somebody that we have heard on the show.
They never saw it coming. Their dignity is yours.
I've been with him, and somebody that really good at the community. This is Extra Game. What's up, Extra?
What's up, everybody? I'm here, and I'm ready to do this.
You're in the lead.
Go ahead. You've been jumping in and
oh yeah, definitely. Ever since the last update came out and they promoted for it, I've been playing a lot more on those maps and I've seen a lot of creative stuff too.
So
I've been more interactive with Forge since Halo 5 basically came out. It's really an eye opener to see what the community can make of it.
Halo 5's Forge is definitely coming along. I think it's probably one of the best points that it's ever been right now. So.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But, back into that as well. It's kind of one, too. Like, you're like, if you're out of Resident Evil. Last but not least, you heard him kind of laugh there in the background. He's just chiming in. We got Shade.
Hey, guys. How's it going? Oh, I'm playing some Iron Banner right now.
All right.
Yeah, I'm currently doing that over on my Twitch channel. So if I seem distracted, that's why.
Change the lead. Victory imminent.
Lost the lead.
I know a lot of people are that, but before I do that, I just kind of want to be going over tonight. Been quite a bit of stuff that's been going on, so we're kind of playing some housekeeping right now. Hopefully, if you are like us in Twitterverse, you've seen some of the craziness that's been going around Titanfall 2. We'll just call it the Titanfall 2 Dilemma. And we'll be talking about that tonight. All kinds of great stuff. You got Gears 4 coming out, you got Mantis, of course, Forza Horizon 3.
This
is
and like Tommy games always talk about that.
This is like the main stuff that's been going on, so
yeah.
But I do want to jump into Destiny first off, and we'll talk about that.
It's like every podcast now we're always talking about Destiny.
I know.
There's nothing wrong with that, guys.
Destiny and eSport or whatever.
Sports, yeah.
Oh my god, all the time, but I guess it's a great of a game if it keeps on coming back to us.
It's like the horrible zombie of games. It will not go away. Now.
No, what's up with that?
Why do you want it to go away, guys? So much hate.
No hate. When it comes to Rise of Iron, a lot of folks either jumped into Destiny or have been nice enough to give Bungie another $30 to continue on with the new expansion. And for those people that have never played Destiny before, and if you're just now getting in on board and you bought the whole pack, that was basically for nothing, you know, it's hard to get any money at all, and you got the entire game, good for you. you have successfully done something that a lot of us have been doing this from day one playing Destiny have, I don't know, even myself, I've referred to it as being a beta. This is an ongoing beta. And it's just nice to know that there's people out there that are grabbing a hold of it and really enjoying it for all the content that has been sprinkled through in the last, is it going on 3 years now? I mean, it feels like at least 7-8 years for me because I've been studying it.
A while.
Yeah. So, it's been a long time coming, so.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people on my timeline, along with Shade, of course. You know, he's been on here playing Rise of Iron. I don't know. I'm going to come back and revisit this one, too. I want to tell you guys how I personally feel about it. But first off, I just want to hear, what are your thoughts on it, first off, Shade? Because I have yet to play it. I did not get Rise of Iron. That was emotional for me. It was hard. So,
yeah.
What you think about it?
Yeah. So, it's, you know, I think a lot of people have heard pretty much what the deal is with it right now. Like, if you're into Destiny, if you have any interest in it at all, you've heard something about Rise of Iron, and that it's short. The main story missions much shorter than the Taken King, which was the previous DLC for it. But the story was actually pretty decent as far as Destiny goes. I'd rank it second among the DLC in terms of the content. Which, I mean, that's not bad. Taken King was fantastic. And, you know, Rise of Iron is below that. But, you know, I think the problem with it, if it would have come out as the first expansion, then people would have loved it. The problem here is that people have sort of gotten, I don't know, tired of the formula, maybe? They can't change it up too much, because it's all still the same game. But, you know, you gotta make it a little bit different to make people want to play it, right? So, I think that's where we're at with Destiny right now. It's a lot of the same, but that's good. I mean, people like playing Destiny, obviously. It's still very successful. So, you know, that's about where I have it. The only thing I haven't done yet in terms of the new expansion is the raid. And that's just because I'm a little bit underleveled. I'm working on that right now.
Oh, I'm way under the level of anyone.
Yeah.
One thing I've noticed from Rise of Iron is that it's gotten more people back into the game than I noticed. I know there's people who used to hate Destiny. Somehow Rise of Iron got them back into it. I don't know if it was the story or something about the content.
Well, I mean, they offered the Gjallarhorn again. So, I mean, that was important to a lot of people. But...
that.
And the Gjallarhorn, yeah. Dude, it's cool. It looks great. The
Gjallarhorn's like a top seller.
But, yeah, so, I mean, it's, what, their fourth expansion? Yeah, so, a game that's able to do four expansions and still be relevant and still have a huge player base like that, you know, again, it's doing a lot right. But people are just getting a little bit tired of the concept, I think. I'm not, though. I'm loving it.
Concept shade, you're actually talking about what? For people that are maybe on the outside looking in, I mean, what does that exactly mean? Because I have an idea where you're going with that.
Yeah, sure. So, I mean, it's a first-person shooter, right? In the vein of many first-person shooters. What's great about it, and this is something I've discovered just recently, you know, it has your typical story campaign stuff, which I think... in terms of the story, it falls very much in line with Call of Duty, maybe? Like, an okay story, not great, but the gameplay itself is addicting, and that's why a lot of people play it. The controls are very easy to deal with, they're very tight. I mean, you know, if... I don't know, I feel like if you are not good at it, it's usually just because you're, like, not good. I mean, I think gamers who are gamers, who've been doing it for a while, have a fair degree of success, no matter what aspect of the game they're playing. Which leads me to PvP, which is something that I was never really a big fan of, mostly because I sucked at it. In Call of Duty, and Halo, and all that stuff, I just kind of suck at PvP. It's not my thing. I must be slow or something. I don't know what it is. But for some reason in Destiny, I feel like either they do a much better job of matchmaking and putting you with people who are on your same skill level, which is awesome. It makes me want to do it a lot more. Or I've gotten better, which I refuse to believe that. I doubt that's the case. But
or what? Keep going, Shade. There has to be a third one in there.
No, that's okay. About it. But, you know, I think it's the most accessible first-person shooter that is out there. And that's saying something.
I would
you're falling behind.
Yeah, I would say that. Yeah, because, like, the game is already starting its own convention slowly. I mean, the reason they had a Destiny convention back in Florida, even though it was small. You know, not a lot of games have conventions. Destiny slowly has a passionate community, even in its community.
It is very catchy. It should be something that is easy for everybody to get a hold of and play. Where
heavy
I feel
ammo
like
inbound.
Destiny falls off the beaten path with a typical Bungie game, doing those little quotation fingers like they do in the presidential election and stuff. where Bungie,
heavy ammo available.
Really falls
5 minutes remaining.
They made their game easy. You're not going to see anybody touting here, you know, gloating about these amazing kills that they got in Destiny PvP because. Everybody gets them, and it's all the time. You know, you can make it no scope, quick scope type. You know, jump 360 in the air, but it's
their
exactly what you're talking
yours.
About in relation to like the Call of Duty following. Now, with that being said, can it be very competitive? Yes, it can be. And in fact, Ty Boy alluded to this earlier. Previous podcast for this one, with Destiny on the forefront of the esports, whether or not we felt like it could be. I
and I was pretty good and entertaining Twitter, so
absolutely. You need something to watch. Anybody can do it. It's not, and that's kind of their whole formula with Destiny. You know, they made Halo, right?
Yeah.
And it was this game, just like what Shade was saying, just like they just couldn't really get that good at it or whatever. Right, Shade?
But yeah, absolutely.
I mean, I don't want to put words in your mouth.
No, you got it. And I really liked Halo and the story. Well, the early story of Halo. And but yeah, like the PvP, you're either great at it or you suck at it. I don't really feel like there's any in between.
Destiny, I mean, it seems like no matter how good you are at video games in general, you can still pick up the controller. Not only a fun time, but usually, you know, get together to get some kill streaks or something like that. And a lot of that, I think, is because that's the way that Bungie set it up. With these super abilities that every character has to support. It doesn't matter whether you're in controls or not, you know, in Call of Duty games and stuff, it is whether or not you can get a care package, or if you can get a streak of kills in a row, you know, without dying, or, you know, things like that. But with this game, it seems like it actually rewards the player just for sticking around and playing.
Because you're almost there.
That power meter is constantly building as you just unleash this devastating hoo-yah, and I got 4 kills in a row, you know. I think that side of it is just, it's kind of silly, and I would like to see that kind of go away. I mean, hopefully if somebody hears this, they're able to influence. I would like to see this in Trials, for instance. Trial of Desires, if they could make that without the super. Let's just see what the game looks like.
Things like that. I think that's a really good idea.
You know, I'm not saying for all of it, because it's the Destiny model, right? I mean, I get that. I completely get that. And I want everybody to be. Let's see, how good you really are. Let's see, you know, and that's about the only way you'll be able to do it. You'll never be able to do it with all the silliness that's going on that all the supers are. So.
Yeah, and I think maybe a pretty decent analogy to this, a completely different game, completely different style of tournament play, but Hearthstone. They split their game basically into a standard format and a wild format. Wild is everything, like anything you can do in the game, like any of the past cards that existed you can use to create decks. Standard is, you know, the newer stuff, it's more refined, and like that's where the competitive scene is. And I think they could do something very similar with Destiny, or really any kind of first-person shooter in terms of competitive play. You know, turn off certain things that allow skill to be more of a factor in the outcome. You know, with Hearthstone, they talk about RNG a lot. And like you were saying here with Destiny, supers are very much an equalizer. So I think that might be a way to go about it, you know, have two different styles of play. And, you know, there are already so many different types of PvP modes in the game. That I think that's something they could easily just slip in and say, okay, this will be our tournament mode. You know, this is gone, this is gone, this is gone. But, you know, you still have the core Destiny experience available to you. And, you know, the greater skill you have, you know, most likely you'll be more successful there.
Exactly. Instead of corner camping with shotguns.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Newer iterations of other games, too, that we'll bring up. A little bit, but I don't know. I could just see it being a lot more for the PvP side of things. But before we go too much further into it, what about this raid? Have you had a chance to play the raid yet?
No, I'm like I said, I'm a little bit underleveled. I'm like 361 right now, and I think they recommend 365. So I'm getting pretty close. But I have seen the raid in its entirety, and I mean, it seems really fun. Like, the mechanics that they use are, like, I think are really interesting. You know, it's very team-centric, team-focused gameplay, which, you know, that's typical of raids, right? Like, if you don't have a good raid group, then there's no way you're going to get through it.
Yeah, I see that.
But, I mean, I think the raids are the strongest part of Destiny. I have loved all of them. And, you know, I don't know if I'm the only one that thinks that. Maybe some people think otherwise. But, like, this is my first real experience dealing with raids and that kind of system. But I thought all of them are really fun. They work really well. And when you have, like, a good raid group together, and there's just so much chaos going on. And when you get through it, like, it feels like a very big sense of achievement. But, you know, I look forward to doing this upcoming raid. And just from what I've seen and what I've heard, people love it. So.
No holding back. Your enemies won't.
All right, now, but anybody else? Extra, have you had a chance to experience any of the rise of the iron?
No, not at all.
Yeah,
I haven't touched Destiny since the base game, sadly. The only reason is because I hate how, I don't want to say Bungie because they don't make all the marketing decisions and all, but I just hate how they marketed the game. Like, you know, how the, you want to say at every new expansion, they, like with the Taken King, like, they had the base game and then they had all the expansions and then they put like a $56 price tag and they did the same thing with the Destiny the collection. They just added extra items. Hey, pay us $60 for this one thing. Or more, it's not
they
one
never
thing,
saw it
but
coming.
You know what I mean.
Their dignity is yours.
Destiny is a great game. I love the game. I've seen a lot of gameplay that I enjoy of the game. I just don't like how they marketed it, that's all. I believe Destiny has great potential, it's a great game, but not right now.
That's a very Capcom thing to do in terms of marketing. I feel like every Capcom game that exists does that exact same thing. I mean, with Street Fighter, you have Super Ultra Mega Super Edition Deluxe or Remix, whatever, right? So, yeah, I agree with that part of it. It's unfortunate for the people who have had the game since it first came out. But again, the problem you run into if you are just buying Destiny now is you're going to have no one to run through the first three raids with. I mean, good luck getting caught up on all that content. It would be a beast to try and do. Unless,
yeah,
you know, you have five friends who also haven't played Destiny.
I haven't updated Destiny since that Star Rays update was out. So, I've almost about a year to catch up on. So.
There's lots waiting there for you. So.
Yeah, I mean, that's the whole Taken King expansion, which, again, was really good.
I bought the Taken King, I never finished it.
Right.
And, like, now with Destiny, my problem is, like, now that I haven't played it in over a year now, almost over a year now,
you and your allies,
I feel like
one.
I'll never get back.
Their glory goes to you, Guardian.
I think that's what's apparently the issue with Destiny is that for those of for those players that wish to stick with their original set of people and play all the way through, I mean, it is one hell of an experience, and I can tell you, I mean, I straight up lost at least a year, maybe even a year and a half of my life just dumping it into, you know, I've gotta stay, and just grinding. Never grinded on me like I grinded on this. And it wasn't even because I wanted to.
You're falling behind.
I had to. If I didn't do it, then I would fall behind. And I didn't want to lose the raid group that I was with, you know, things like that. But back to like what Extra was saying, in regards to the way that purchased the Rise of Iron, is because this last little queue that they decided to basically hold back the Taken King exclusive content that came out for PlayStation users. They were supposed to have that available for us during the Rise of Iron time period. We're waiting on it. I know we've talked about this before, but it's something very, very vague.
they were like, should be on or around. And whenever they made that final decision of, well, the Rise of Iron is going to come out, we're still not going to release the Taken King stuff until the end of 2017. I was so about that. Different guns and weapons and stuff, and I want to know what these maps are like, or I want to feel like what these strikes are like, and I want to experience that with my friends. And
lost the lead.
Destiny 2 has come out.
No one shares the glory
and
on that one.
By now. That time, everybody's moved on.
Heavy
to a different
ammo
game.
Inbound.
I just lost, you know, a portion of the game. Some people would say, you know, chill. You know, it's not that big of a deal. It's just a couple. It's just a couple of strikes.
5 minutes remaining.
Saying, just,
heavy ammo
it's
available.
It's not right with them doing that. Just flip the script halfway through it and be like, oh, sorry, you don't get your exclusive content until next year. Come back and see us.
Yeah, I mean, I can't speak much to that. I do play on PlayStation, so I didn't have to deal with that, and I'm not too familiar with those woes, which, I mean, I guess, fortunately, unfortunately. But, you know, that is one problem with the exclusive content, no matter what console you're on. You know, you're going to make people unhappy, right? Like, I mean, I think of... what was the most recent Tomb Raider called? Rise of the Tomb Raider. Yeah, like, it's coming to both consoles, but it's not coming to PlayStation 4 until a year after. Which, you know, by that time, it's old news, and yeah, it's cheaper, and includes all the DLC, but, like, this, you know, everyone's kind of moved on.
Yeah, all these new games come out.
Right. Like, I don't have time to play a year-old game. But, yeah, so console exclusive stuff is tough. I get that, you know, developers have to do it sometimes, and companies pay to make it happen, but, you know, it sucks. There's really no getting around it.
Yeah.
Another chance
until
of glory.
This game, I've done a pretty good job about keeping myself away from these games like Destiny that have split between two different consoles. And it was for a good reason. This is the exact reason why. And I know that in the future, I'm just gonna kind of stay away from it because I don't care to play this console anymore. Exclusively, come by our box if you want to play this game. Bullshit. And there I just said it. So let's go on down the road. How about that? I would like to check out the Rise of Iron sometime in the future, hopefully. They will offer some type of a package. and I'm holding out for it because he's like, every time it's out there, you buy it at $60, and that's if you're just getting the base one. Then within a few weeks, it's dropped down to $40. And then within 6 months, it's dropped down to $29. So, I'm just really surprised at least one more set that's available out there. And I like what you were saying, Shade. I do agree about the raid portion. That was the most part of Destiny for me, was raids. But the most important piece of that was experiencing it with the people that I was running with.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you didn't have those people, then it didn't matter what the raid was. And it was that you've never done before with a group of people, because I guarantee you're going to have other people that have already done it another time. So, no matter how good they are at being quiet about it or whatever, they're still not going to give you the full experience of, you know, testing it out on your own. It's just one of those things.
Glory demands more, Guardian!
And that's why you should join Xbox Clubs.
Yes.
Which then you guys can all share in the tears that have been cried over the exclusivity content. So, as for another show, let's go ahead and beef this thing up and jump into some of the new stuff coming out from Forza. The Forza Horizon 3 has finally hit, and it's on PC and it's on console.
Xbox and Play Anywhere title.
I tell you what, man. I've got guys that are playing it on PC and they're loving it.
I didn't even download it on the PC yet. I have just been playing it on Xbox, and it's pretty nice. Australia looks really nice in the game. Going to the beach is awesome. Driving randomly in the dirt roads, farms, whatever, it's awesome. Auction house is awesome. Always loved the auction house in Forza. Obviously, the Warthog is one of the greatest
things.
And actually, the Warthog actually goes 118 miles an hour.
I thought it was 117
miles. Yeah, on my screen, it's like messed up. It says 118.
Aww.
But still.
Your box must be messed up then.
Yeah.
It's because he's not playing it on PC, man.
But anyways, everything about the game is nice. When you go into the city, it's nice. When you go into like the outback area, which is like the deserty area, it's really nice. At the festivals, it's awesome. You get to upgrade them as you go on. The thing about Forza, and I know Scott will say something about this, it's too serious. Forza Horizon will never be what Burnout was.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, Burnout Paradise is the best.
Burnout Paradise was the best. Nothing will ever be like Burnout. I wish there was a Burnout coming out. Forza's awesome, but then again, Forza Horizon is awesome. It'll bring more people to this, like, it'll bring more people to that series rather than motorsport, because you can free roam and all that, but still, it doesn't have that arcadey feel. Mm-hmm. And it's something about
it's a simulator. It's not an arcade title, it's a simulator.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But one thing I like about Forza Horizon 3, I don't remember if it was in 2 or not, because I'm not that much of an expert at Forza games, is the online co-op. And we've done it up to 3 people. I'm not exactly sure how many people you can do it with, but it's pretty awesome. You can get it. It's a better way of getting less bored of playing by yourself or doing online free roam with your friends. So I think that was a cool addition. And obviously the driver tars as well. Like while you're driving around in the roads, you can challenge your driver tars to like a certain race, go to a certain point. And some of them are labeled easy, medium, hard. And eventually you'll have like a task to find a driver tar for like your lineup against your team lineup. And you challenge them. When you beat them, they come onto your lineup. Then I guess I've got 4 of them, but once you get 4 of them, you should be able to swap them out after that. So overall, Forza Horizon 3 is a great game, great looking game. It's just not Burnout.
Well, and yeah, it's not Burnout. Nothing is Burnout, but it looks fantastic. It's one of the best looking games I've seen.
It
looks very
pretty. The Iron Lords are watching.
But yeah, the club's idea was pretty cool too. You have up to 1,000 people in there.
Did they also have something that's called like a drone mode or something?
Oh yeah, I haven't gotten to use that.
First blood goes to you. Excellent exchange. You're in the lead.
I'd probably just get lost at that point. I'm like, okay, this is like a game.
And the music is actually pretty good too. I like the whole groove. Thing with the games, you don't like put the songs on the PC.
Well, it sounds like a lot of people were having fun with it. I almost got overly enticed to purchase it the other night, and I just decided against it because
it didn't work for me. But I got a $15 gift card towards
I saw that. I don't know. Again, it'll be probably one of those games that I'll check it out.
that for free on Xbox Gold, or
this fall probably has to be one of the worst falls for me when it comes to games. You know, there's not a Halo out for some reason. I'm spending so much money on game stuff this year.
And you're just spending money on it. Right now.
I know, right?
There you go. Welcome to real life. All your time in the
yeah, just wait till you're a parent. You don't even spend your money on yourself.
That's right. That's right. So,
it sounds like fun.
I want to do it. It's just not gonna be like right now. Well, it might be one of those Christmas time pull the triggers if it was like $19, $20 or whatever.
Seems like so far, it's been like piling.
You're on every
Xbox exclusive games where I get to use the Xbox exclusive games like Record and Forza, Forza 4 coming out. It seems to be taking
excellent spot
there over Battlefield 1, Battlefield 2, Watch Dogs, and other games that are coming.
Yeah, I've been hearing a lot of Record talks.
Oh yeah.
Their glory goes to you.
Oh yeah. I got some hands on. This game seems like it got quiet pretty fast. And I understand people playing games not going to talk to a lot of people. But overall, I think the game is great. The controls feel awesome, and
the colors are like way crazy. What are you talking about?
But yeah, Record is like an older style game for sure. Especially when it comes to the end. It's more of an older style game. And it has a drive to it too.
Double down.
Single player, but it has a drive to it. So, yeah, I mean,
yes.
It's good. It's only 40 bucks.
Fantastic work. The crest is yours, Guardian.
I think some different sales gone off real quick.
Add a grindy element to a single
while you're in the middle of the game, you're like, oh, I'm never gonna go into this game again. These end up being all wrong. You're gonna use like most of the game to actually to be.
I think that's really cool for people that are not into, like, you know, like Shade said earlier.
Yeah, I'd say it's a Shade game.
Yeah.
Wow, Shade game.
There you go, man. You can jump on
heavy ammo on the way.
Been recommended for Shade.
That means a lot.
They never saw it coming.
That's yeah.
Cool. Their dignity is
like,
yours.
I can tell who's game it is. It's a great game too.
Heavy ammo available. Only 5 minutes left.
It looks cool, but yeah. I'm good.
Gears of War 4 is your type of game.
Now that's my kind of game.
That's your kind of game.
I gotta be honest, man. I'm so bad at Gears.
Dude, I take it to heart. But I mainly play for like the multiplayer, but Horde mode is actually awesome, and they're gonna play a little bit.
I've always loved Horde mode.
Oh yeah.
I have no judgment for the third game. I've always
no one shares.
Yeah, I didn't even get my hands on judgment at all. So, but I'm looking forward to playing that with a group of people in my reaction. And the campaign seems to be like awesome.
Just think of trailer.
Yeah.
I like the way this whole environmental
Your honor is shattered.
Yeah,
a lot of my gameplay.
I have to put off Titanfall 2, I think. But
one thing about Gears of War 4 is basically the Halo 5 is the But it seems like Microsoft is going further with Gears of War 4 with the promoting, and lately they've been all over, like, I think right now they're in Miami. I guess that's hosting an event, and so many, they're giving so many celebrities like the top, so many posts all over Twitter, like all these rappers that I probably never heard of. Apparently there's a lot of forces that are in war, I learned, and on the Xbox One home screen, there's a special tab for Gears of War 4 that tells you all this cool stuff, vault room and stuff, which is awesome. So Microsoft all that is going on.
Like you see this, like, you trying at least the campaign side of it, you know, probably portrait and stuff.
Absolutely.
Gears multiplayer, I have so much respect for those guys. I'm like, no, I can't do that, man. It's so hard for me. I don't know, there's just something about the mechanics. I can't jump up in the air, you know?
Sorry, I just have to interrupt this very quickly. I just got MVP in my most recent match of Iron Banner, so... Thank you very much.
Yeah. Good job, Shade.
Yeah. Top of the leaderboard there.
Awesome. Oof. Can you show how many supers you got to use during that match?
Two.
Oh.
23 kills. That's actually. Two supers.
Look at this.
Yeah. I know. Hey, guys. Best K to D ratio in the match at 1.92. I know. It's not bad.
Wow.
And how much you want to bet at the end of the match? You got no loot, did you?
Yeah, the loot was pretty. I think I got two modes of light.
You get a Galahorn, like,
oh, one mode of light, actually. One, it just showed me.
That was another thing about that game. It was so frustrating. It's like you'd be at the top of the leaderboard and it would give you nothing.
Yeah.
And then the people at the bottom, it was like, oh, you lost. So here's the best weapon that everyone's been grinding all week for.
No, that's exactly how it is. And, like, yeah. I get why they do that, right? Like, not everyone's going to get MVP. This is the first time I've ever gotten MVP in PvP. So this is actually very odd for me. But, you know, if they give the best loot to MVPs, then you're going to have a whole slew of people who don't get something just because they suck at PvP. And, like, I don't know. Maybe that's okay. You know.
Exactly.
But,
sorry.
This game isn't that, right? That's Call of Duty. That's Battlefield 1.
No, Destiny doesn't seem to be made for PvP.
It rewards the most common vote.
this game PvP, I know we already talked about this, but this game PvP reminds me of GoldenEye. Like, it's for everybody. It doesn't matter how good you are, how bad you are. Like, it's for everybody. Everyone can have fun. Like, even if you suck, you still have fun. That's not the case in Call of Duty or Battlefield. If you suck, then it's a terrible time and you never want to go back.
Oh, yeah.
I'll never play that a game again.
Yeah, exactly.
360 no scope, dude.
Yeah, I've had plenty of Call of Duty PvP where I had, like, two kills to 24 deaths, and I'm just like, this is stupid. That, like, I don't even know why I do it. Like, it's a waste of my time. Anyway, sorry. Just had to interrupt the entire podcast for that.
Excellent banter. I enjoyed it. It's good. let's talk about some Titanfall 2 action, man.
Yeah, for all you guys, have any of you tried Titanfall? I mean, I know No Life did back when it first came out, but have any of you?
The only experience I had with... Oh, go ahead.
Oh, me?
Yep.
Like, do you feel your life is stronger now? I own the first game, and I've owned all the DLC because it was free on Games with Gold on Xbox a couple months ago.
So be it.
Yippee. And I love the game. I played it on it. I got, I guess you can say, Prestige 1. And I love the mechanics game, how they brought Titans into a FPS game, and that was a new feature that everyone's loved. And of course, it has some of its downsides, like every game does. But it's a great franchise so far.
Don't get too cocky out there.
Yeah, my only exposure to it was playing it at E3. So that was Titanfall 2. I did not play the first Titanfall. But did play the most recent one at E3, and it was fun. I mean, I didn't really know what I was doing because I hadn't piloted a Titan before, and you know, it was sort of unfamiliar with for me. But it felt like, you know, it felt pretty Call of Duty. But there were a lot of other things in the game that certainly separate it from the Call of Duty franchise. So I was very intrigued by it, and I'm glad that it's coming to PlayStation now.
Oh yeah, it felt good on a PlayStation controller, not gonna lie. I did good that game E3, but yeah. Titanfall 2, I enjoyed my time with it, especially with the test.
Show
they
me
did
your
on
light.
My, so.
Keep growing your
Twisted,
light.
Have you?
So I too, just like Extro, had never touched the original Titanfall. But I did get it with Games with Gold. And without being like him, I did not even touch it yet. So I'm not.
Dude.
I know.
Dude.
I know. Blow my mind. Oh my god. But yeah, it's
no,
just.
But I enjoy Titanfall 1. I no life the hell out of it. I don't know how many hours I have, but more hours than probably Destiny, if you counted the beta in that too. I no life that beta like it was my job. But no. But. Titanfall 2, I enjoyed it. There's a lot of new things in it. A lot of people hated it. I like the new grapple system where you grapple around the map and you can grapple right into your Titan and all that, or go into someone else's Titan. I think that's a really cool feature.
I'll grab other people and just kick them. You can do that in Nidale too, which is was my favorite thing to do in the beta.
Yeah, and obviously. Wall running is back in Titanfall 2, which Titanfall started in the beginning before Call of Duty did it. In case anyone wants to make a case, Call of Duty started it first.
Here you go.
But no, I'm not gonna buy. I don't think I'm buying Titanfall 2 day one, just because. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know yet. It's gonna be a weird decision for me, unless it's another target glitch or something. But it seems like Titanfall 2 is getting so much popularity without Respawn trying to do anything. Obviously, they did the whole single-player trailer, which looks awesome about Titanfall 2. I almost forgot about the campaign. The campaign seems really cool. But the thing is, a lot of these fans have been making Titanfall 2 maybe a little bit popular due to some childish reactions to some stuff that's like, I don't know, this is stupid.
This is what we were talking about with the Titanfall 2 dilemma earlier, so.
Yeah, so, I forgot his name, one of the developers for Titanfall 2 posted the first physical copy of Titanfall 2, which was a PS4 copy.
No.
And so, I'm not gonna put any names out. What?
Holler. PS4, man. Of course it was.
I know. I mean, why not? Why would some people get mad about it? I mean, it's the first time for Titanfall getting on PS4, so why not? But then I'm not going to put any names out here. Several people follow this too, so it's not one person's fault. Xbox fans got offended by that picture. So apparently, since Xbox is marketing rights, that guy should not post
Bravo
a picture
team.
Of the PS4 copy.
You think?
But... that's just stupid. Like,
prove you are worthy of the Iron Lord.
Okay. Like, I don't know what to say about
well,
that.
I think it comes full circle, Ty. I mean, initially I kind of understood where it was coming from, and now that you're saying exactly how it all played out, I have seen it.
Excellent. Let the battle be joined.
You're seeing it, and I'm like, you know, kind of.
Their glory, that was an argument. Securing the crest is vital. Good work.
Taking the specialty content and moving it off a whole year later. It's you got people paying the same amount of money. You know, so that's the kind of way I see it. Maybe they're worried that one or the other is going to have exclusivity rights taken away or something like that. So I mean, you might want to look at it like that too.
Yeah.
I didn't feel that way personally about Titanfall 2, and that's just because I hadn't played the original. But somebody like yourself that really got into the maybe they really wanted to buy some of this thing. You know? I mean, a new game comes out like this, and you got people that, hell, they're planning to launch their YouTube channel and rebrand their Twitter, you know, all this different stuff. And it seems like it's that way for every new game that comes out. It doesn't even matter if it's the 2 or the 3 or whatever.
Yeah.
So they might have been getting kind of bent off about that, being like, What? What are you doing this on Sony? Is it something you get? You know, not a kick about. You know, still, I just kind of understand where they might be.
I just hope the time to pull through.
Allies have your back.
Ooh, crossplay.
That'll be the day.
That'll be awesome.
Gotta do some Rocket League, guys.
Oh, no. The Rocket League is interesting. Yeah, the whole if you guys follow me on Twitter at TimeBoyN17, talk about a battle with me or whatever. But
they never saw it coming. Their dignity is yours.
The whole fanboy stuff that between, I mean, I get you're an Xbox Scorpio fan, you're a PS4 pro player. You know, and you don't need to brag about certain stuff.
Their crest belongs to you now.
Scroll up a little bit. What are you talking about?
What?
The next what? What are you talking about?
You know.
Does that thing... That's not gonna really exist, right? Like...
I don't think so.
It's never gonna come out.
I feel like this is Final Fantasy VII Remake all over again, but for a system instead of a game. Like,
this is Half-Life 3.
Yeah, oh, there you go. There you go.
Another thing I want to talk about. I wanted to see if you guys thoughts on this one. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. It's coming out, right? You have to buy the legacy of Modern Warfare Remastered. So apparently they're not gonna come separately, they're gonna come into I guess one disc.
Yeah.
130 gigabytes.
Like when I saw all the information about this, it said like it came from a French what's the word one called? It's kind of like French GameStop. I forgot the name. It's I would load it up right now, but I'm fine. So. But basically, they kind of released early copies of the Infinite Warfare Legacy Edition piece of the disc. And on the back, it says that minimum.
So
the amount of space you need, is 130 gigabytes. Mind.
Are they gonna start like packaging this thing with an external hard drive?
No. I know, right? That's a whole entire Xbox 360 hard drive.
I looked on some of the articles saying that how it might be just maybe the other is all the DLC that's going to come after it. But I know on PS4 that Infinite Warfare
heavy
is like
49
gigabytes, something like that. So and then if you add the remaster to Modern Warfare, it's not really that unbelievable to believe. But 130 gigabytes.
Heavy
when I saw that number, I was like,
only 5 minutes
holy
left.
Crap! I remember like 5 years ago how games were like only like 10 gigabytes, and now I see this, and it's like a weird thought evolving. So, holy crap.
No one shares the glory on that one.
Brand new bundle packages, just the game title on a disc, and then like the statue figurine, and inside of it is like a 2 terabyte hard drive. And you're like, Jesus, that's awesome. 2 terabyte drive? They're like, oh wait, a terabyte and half of it goes towards
that crest is yours, Guardian.
So is that 130? Is that Infinite Warfare and Modern Warfare, or is it just the one?
Yeah, it's
both. Legacy Edition.
Okay,
and they're supposed to be all one disc.
Jeez,
man, I don't know what to say about that.
Well, I had faith I was gonna buy all the Modern Warfare and Masters, but it looks like they'll never happen all over.
I'm just not interested in purchasing this new title at all. And I mean, I'd like to play the remaster just for the nostalgic reasons, but I think that they knew that. That's the reason why they're like, pity that. Please try a new crappy game.
I bought and played every Call of Duty, like, since the very first game until Black Ops 3, because I kind of got done by the franchise. Because I when I played Black Ops 2, I'm like, I played the crap out of that game. And I was pretty good, actually, but I just, like, you know, every Call of Duty game, it adds new features, it adds new abilities and all that, like, in Black Ops 3, Call of Duty Ghosts, how they want to expand the game, and, you know, they added leaning in that glory one, comes and then to you. That space mission.
Jesus. You were pretty good at that one.
Yeah.
So, hey, Shade.
Yeah.
You know that guy that you were talking about earlier that was in, you know, multiplayer? You just couldn't stand it, you know? You just weren't that great at it because of that guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was Extro.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Probably not when I was playing, because how old are you, Extro? You're a younger kid, right?
Oh, God. I'm like half your age.
Yeah, so, yeah, it wasn't him I was playing. But, probably Extro's dad.
That's why. I just got that mental shot. Though. You're like, oh, you're slinging down the controller, not enjoying it. Oh, that's smart.
Yeah, I just kind of got sick of finding a Call of Duty game every year, and, you know, just replaying the, like, I don't want to say competitive, because every game does, like, bring new features to multiplayer, and I kind of did buy Call of Duty Ghosts campaign. I know I'm that small, very, very small majority, but that's
tumble down. Three opponents now. Securing the crest.
I mean, it was
fight.
There. It was a different good campaign, work. But the thing was is that they always ended the exact same way.
No, sorry, fine. Nothing goes to
slow
third.
Motion and the guns. Grab it and shoot the bad guy in the head.
Or it's a knife. Could be a knife.
Or a knife. You know, it's always a weapon. Full motion. But yeah, I didn't play it right now, like you can tell. Love it. Well, I know that we haven't had anything. Are we wrapped up there? Is there anything else you want to throw in there, Ty?
I just wanted to let you guys know I'm on the verge of being MVP.
They never saw it coming.
This is unbelievable. I don't know what's happening.
Their dignity is yours.
I need a podcast and stream more often. Yeah, like I've already wrapped it up. I could just put the controller down and I'd have it. This is unbelievable. You guys are great.
I haven't even done a super yet.
You won today.
Twice again, but hey,
hey, I did want to say one more thing. We talked about this on our outline, Ty, but recently in Halo 5, they have tried to do some reworking around the breakout game type.
Oh, yeah, what was up with that?
And I got a chance to play it. I only did maybe 30 minutes worth of games on it, but that was because it's just not really for me, which... The original breakout title itself was not really for a lot of folks. It basically changed Halo as we knew it to more just that rounds based, you know. There was no shields, and it seemed like it was really weird too, like the game mechanics. Like you could shoot somebody like 2-3 times in the back as they're running and that wouldn't kill them, but one headshot and they were dead, you know. And it was just kind of strange to get used to that whenever you're used to kind of bullet sponging people in Halo as it was, you know, because of how shields were. So it was kind of like it was the absolute opposite from a typical Halo feel. But now they've switched it again. The original breakout game types had no motion sensors either. And usually the starting weapon was just a pistol, which now everyone spawns in with, get this, a shotgun.
Oh, what?
Yeah, so everyone spawns in with a shotgun, and it says you're secondary, but it's still there, okay? And there's motion tracker.
That's weird.
There's shields.
Oh, yeah, I heard about the shields part. I didn't know about the shotgun part.
Shields, too. It's like it's not the normal Halo shield. It's just this weird, like, you can take a little extra damage, but then you can still get headshotted. And I'm like, I don't know how to play this game, and I'm so infuriated. I'm just...
I've been on and off with Halo 5 again.
I've really not enjoyed Breakout. Like, it's probably my least favorite out of all the game modes on Halo 5. And honestly, like, since I hear all these changes, I need to play it again to see if I would even want to play it in my spare time. Because, but the way you described it, it sounds like... What?
Yeah, it's one of those things where you're just like, as someone that's used to playing the game, you're looking at yourself within just a few times of getting killed, like, what? How did that, what? And you just really get frustrated. If you're somebody like me, it's just like instantaneous. It's like, forget it. I don't ever want to do that. Because you shot somebody 2-3 times as they're running around the corner and didn't get a kill for it. But then you walked around the corner and boom, headshot instant, or a shotgun. And you're like, I don't know. It's just, it's one of those things. I mean, I actually applaud 343 for going outside of the box and trying to do something different with the original Breakout. That's important. I mean, I'm glad that they stuck with all the core stuff and did all these other things, but then they also had this like unique, different game type too. Just like with Firefight, really, they've completely changed it and giving you the opportunity to jump in there with a, you know, big group of people and stuff, and it's really cool. It's something different. Even though Breakout has not turned out to be everything I think that they wanted it to be.
Yeah, I thought they expected more from like HCS and all that.
Right. I mean, nobody wanted to do it in the competitive community. They're all like, nope, that's stupid. So, yep.
They, like Ricochet.
Yep. You don't want nothing to do it. Exactly. Ricochet's another one. I thought Ricochet was probably one of the best new game types added since out of anything that Reach was. When they put in Headhunter, I actually liked Headhunter.
Iron Banner, it was supremacy.
Difficult at times.
Bravo team.
But Ricochet was so much better. Yeah. But Ricochet was so much better.
The Iron Lords are watching.
I wish they would do stuff like that, but I don't want to go off on this big thing. All I'm trying to say is that I wish that other game developers would do like what 343 did with Breakout and just try out different stuff. Keep the core component of your game. Make sure that that's there and represented somewhere in the multiplayer side of it. But try something outside of the box. Because now I get this case, yeah, definitely was not.
You're in the lead.
You know, scratch the board and let's play something different. You know, whenever Halo 6 comes out, let's play something different. Just want to see what it's going to be like.
They never saw it coming. Their dignity is yours.
Since that didn't make it to our cut list, I did want to say one more thing, Ty. Remember how I was tweeting out a few months ago about that really
awesome
Xbox 10.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was floating around for a while, that was like an exclusive to some of the conventions and stuff. And I was to trade them and all kinds of stuff. I was like really excited and I saw that Xbox came out and saying, you know, he does for the 10, you know, whatever. I was like, yeah, sweet. Well, I guess it's because it's like Breast Cancer Awareness Month, but I was the winner for October. And I was like, that's great. And they got my details and stuff. And they said, yeah, we're going to send you a pin. And I'm so pumped, dude. You can ask Ty, but I'm jazzed. Without a stupid It's like a little cool pin. So it comes in and opens the package. All the pins. Breast cancer awareness. Bright, Mary Kay looking pin.
Lucky you, dude.
Don't say nothing. This is awesome. I don't know. Look, I really like the pin a lot, but
you're falling behind.
Dude, I'll take it. All right, I'll take it. That's
fine. I mean, I
can rock the mic
for this month, but I think you got it.
I was really so shocked when you came in. I was like, yes!
It's a great card. It's a great card, but do they really have to catch us?
Alright, well, Chase, do you have anything else you want to throw in here for him?
No, you guys are just my good luck charm for Iron Banner, so expect me to call you guys up tomorrow when I'm playing some more.
And what's your Twitch chat?
Shady8.
Nice. Hit him up, turn on your notification. Just say hello in the stream sometime, would you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Extra, sign out for us, man.
Oh, sign out, wow. We got you.
Well, guys,
thank you for listening to the podcast. Hope you enjoyed it. I know today everyone had a chance to talk about their opinions on some topics that we would love to discuss. And we hope that you'll listen to us again.
Of course, you gotta remember the stay rectified part.
Oh, yeah.
Stay rectified.
Stay rectified.
I think I'm gonna start streaming a lot every single time now. There won't be a problem.
You should. And we meant that right out of nowhere.
The next goal is not Destiny.
Yeah, and if so, we need to put it towards the end goal or something. Because we did the same thing. The same thing in the last podcast, too. We talked about Destiny straight.
I bet every podcast you've been on, Twisted's all about Destiny.
It seems that way. The worst part is that we did the Pokecast for 35. We talked about Pokemon. And then we talked about Destiny for 36. And now 37.
We're talking about something.
Well, I mean, Rise of Iron just released. I think people can be okay with Destiny right now.
Heavy ammo inbound.
I'll just let down. I'm really disappointed.
Oh, hey, Rectify Gaming is now hosting my channel.
Five minutes remaining. Heavy ammo available.
We had some people coming down the
stream. Destiny community. Crazy, like divided, and I think a lot of it has to do with what you guys heard me talking about earlier with this Xbox players and PlayStation players. And I had guys that I was playing with like every day for hours, and the Taken King came out and they went and bought Sony PlayStation, and they've just disappeared and they're not even around. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, how do you do that shit to people, dude? I mean, just... I'm glad that they did. I'm trying to keep up with all these people, and then he goes and leaves, and then he takes another one of his buddies, and they all go get PlayStations. And it's like, now what? You know, you lose your raid team, now what? Now what are you gonna do?
Team up with time, man.
So... Well, yeah, Tristan was almost to the point where he can run the vault of glass by himself now.
Alright.
He's like, isn't this the part where you're here?
No.
Fucking
what?
Yeah.
Don't be that guy. No, it's like I'm just good. Hey,
Twisty,
what was that gun I got?
That was so cool.
Oh my god,
that's so cool. You got super good advice.
The very first raid. That's ridiculous.
Yeah. The second chest is the Gorgon chest that you got on, and it was super good advice.
Yeah, that was my gun. I played Destiny a lot. You know, when it first came out, and ever since, and I never got Gallus. Never. It's so frustrating. And I think I was on, like, vacation or something the week they had Gjallarhorn, like, Zerg selling Gjallarhorn.
Yeah,
so I never got it.
Oh.
enemies almost won.
They didn't have any options like to convert those. Oh, you had to get strange coins from doing the Nightfall. Oh, so I don't want to.
Did you see
my video from when I got the Gallimore? Oh, dude. I got to change it.
Well,
I was major passionate for this. I followed it.
Your honor is shattered.
And still to this day, I'm just, it's just like, it's like they throw it back.
Glory demands more, Guardian!
Again, I know, but the notification I have for the stream when someone follows is Xbox record that.
Oh, yeah, I heard that.
I always hear
it. From.
Every day, Twisted, I always hear your voice.
Yeah, it pops up in the feed, too, on the left hand side, and I didn't even see it because I have so much stuff going on with the stream. It said Twisted Shots got. I completely didn't even see it until the post game.
Yeah. That's funny.
Yep.
Sorry, guys. No MVP that round. Sorry to let you down.
Xbox, record that.
That's pretty serious right there.
Hell yeah, it was, dude.
Xbox, record that.
Now take Cortana, record that, or you can still do Xbox.
Oh yeah, I still say Xbox.
Not on board with Cortana?
I do Cortana.
Nope. I took her off because I have it linked to my Windows 10 app. And every time I say that, not only does it do something on my computer, but it does it on my Xbox.
Remember, I say Cortana and Blue Snowballing sometimes. It'll freaking pop up with something here and take me to Bing. Oh my
god. Ooh, I got a new vehicle. The S40 Iron Revelry.
Blah, blah.
Oh, stop that. Blah.
I'm going to pretend I know what that is and say that you did a good job.
Thank you. It was all skill. It was really just skill that made that happen. Oh, pretty sick helm. Nice. It's got horns on the side. Because.
PS4, oh.
I know, it's great. I know.
Some guy today that I know from work, he was trying to get me to buy a PS4. I'm like, no, I'm not buying a PS4, dude. Not yet. If I buy a PS4, I'm getting the Pro because it makes no sense. I just get the regular one.
Mm-hmm. Well, the Slim would be, it's what, $100 cheaper or $50?
I don't know. I mean, PS4
pretty good, the regular one.
Lots of options.
I'm getting Scorpio.
Hey, if anybody's wanting to get their hands on Elgato HD60, I've got mine, and I'm selling
it. You still
it,
do?
So let me know. Yeah.
I think you got rid of it. I think you still already. I think you already did sell it.
No, that's what I'm saying. I've had it up for sale at some local stuff here, and everybody's wanting to lowball me and stuff. They're like, "Yeah, I'll give you $20 for it." I'm like, "Fuck you."
Jeez.
Fuck you.
It's like the 30 FPS one.
So, yeah, I just think a lot of people don't even know what it is. So, I figured I'd open it up to my community guys and say, "Hey, if anybody's wanting to." To step up to the HD60. It's not the 60S, but just the HD60. And I was selling it for $125, so that's pretty damn good.
So. I can't wait for my new desk setup. Oh, man, I can't wait to get multiple monitors on my PC.
Oh, it's so great. I don't know how people do one monitor.
I know, right?
I mean, just right now, like, I've got all my recording and, like, the podcast and Twitch stuff on one screen, and I'm playing my PS4 on my second screen. Like, it's incredible.
You're like, I need to get more monitors. My goal before the Scorpio comes out is get a 4K.
That's something to do.
4K monitor, you got it. High roller.
Yeah. 4K something to game on, so TV monitor.
All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and get off here.
All right, dude. Good,
as always, stay twisted.
I was gonna stream, but I'm too tired.
Yeah, well, it's like what time is it? Like 1:15?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, get out of here.
Oh.
It's time for you to go to bed. You have a long day tomorrow.
I know I don't.
Okay, well. Then stream. What are you going to do, Forza? Alright. Well, that was fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. That was kind of like the director's cut of the podcast. See behind the scenes there. Okay, so I actually had a pretty freaking awesome run there on Iron Banner. Like I said, I had never gotten MVP in any kind of PvP before, so I did it twice in a row there. Makes me feel really good about myself. And I'm sure it won't happen again for, like, you know, 4 years or something. These are relatively close. I think, let's see, 1050 off, let's give me 750. So I mean, if I do both of those, then I'll rank up 3 and do this, but I think I will go to the tower first and do this. I don't even know what that is, so let's find out. And there might be some crucible quests that I can pick up. You guys want some music? So I finally finally figured out. This is how behind the times I am. I finally figured out how to do PC audio, PS4 audio, and my microphone audio all at the same time. Which is why I was able to let you guys listen to the podcast while we were recording it. Let's see what I got here. This is Lupe Fiasco Radio on Pandora. I'm gonna have it on there for a little while.
I'm listening. Thanks again.
Oh, arc grenades.
Thank you, Guardian.
Probably gonna suck at that.
I've seen you.
Well, now let's see. I wonder if I can find somebody to do the Nightfall with. Because it'd be nice to get that done out of the way.
Salvaged relic data is now decrypted.
I want the Nightfall. Where are you? I don't even know what the Nightfall is this week. Let's see if he needs another.
Come to study the Traveler?
Well, I'm at least a respectable light level for the Nightfall. Last week I was way under level. I was like 355 or something. So I pretty much got carried through. What am I at now? 361? Yeah. It's not bad. I think recommend is like 360. He's got another guy and we can just hop right in. Let me see what 360 still says very hard. There we go.
Yep. You can drone on me, my party's open. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, just drone up.
House of Devils marked you as public enemy number one after you trashed their prime servitor, but your old friend Sepix Prime is back, and apparently better than ever thanks to the Devil Splicers and Siva. Zavala is not too happy about the idea of the Splicers playing Godmaker, and I can't blame him.
So what you're saying is it's time we return to the scene of the crime. I'm sure the Fallen will be happy to see us.
I wonder if I should... Yeah. I don't think he has a third.
The Hive are still holding ground in the refinery, but I'm also tracking multiple SIVA energy signatures. Well, that's new.
Oh, that's bad.
splicers have a laser grid blocking the way. I should be able to disable it. In the meantime, do not touch the lasers, and watch my back.
Yo.
Yo, drawing up on you guys? Acid boy?
Yep. Yeah, John and Acid. We're already in here. The other dude doesn't have a mic, but he seems to be on point.
That's fine, that's fine.
Yeah, just a Nightfall.
Yeah, I just beat him out of here. It's just gonna do it.
Word.
Raph really fast.
Dude, you been fucking around with that Iron Banner yet? It is so, it is so different. Yeah, it's great. Like, it's much more generous with the loot. You're getting, like, a legendary every win guaranteed, but, like, at least every other match, like, even if you're not winning. Like, so that's kind of cool.
Also, light dropping.
And, yo, just higher than what you are. All the blues are the same, like, 340. Or they encrypt into, you know, like that crap, but yeah, any legendary is like guaranteed at least one, if not 2 points higher than you are already.
Okay, that's probably better than being a blue.
Pretty much, yeah, that's like the thing to do right now, as far as it seems. Yeah. And the bounties are super easy, so you can bang those out and it gives out some nice rewards.
Oh, that was a mistake on my end. I thought the third guy was already in. But he just...
through, but we've got major Hive reinforcements inbound. Good luck. Guardian down.
juggle his own.
It's match game, so it's like, yeah. Luckily, nothing that works against us, but you just have to do the damage such that they are. Otherwise, it's not as effective. Oh, damn it. Did surprise me. Thank you.
Trying to get all the shields back.
Got it. Grid's clear.
There we go.
Let's get out of here.
Well. Especially considering we're going to split up for a good part of that.
Guardian, I've got reports of hive activity near the Devil's Lair. You seeing anything?
Yeah. We've definitely got hive. And apparently they hold a grudge because they're mad. And I think they're letting the Fallen know it.
It's nice to have some down here as a distraction.
Guardian down.
Oh shit. Damn. Oh, sorry, I'm forgetting that one. Yeah, I keep you posted.
Oh, yeah.
Why would the splicers rebuild Sepix? They already have Siva.
I can make a guess. Maybe an offer to the other devils. A show of power. You know, in Siva we trust, and in Siva all things are possible. Get in there, and show them that their god is nothing but metal and tech.
Sepix perfected, in all his glory.
Thank you.
to run this time.
You are entering a world you do not understand.
Oh, no.
Good stuff. Oh, don't worry about her, Guardian. She's still mad about what you did to her ship.
But we need cloaking words tech I never said.
The Warmind bunker's got the code we need.
I did, yes, yes. I did used to be a radio DJ, it's true. It's painfully obvious to most people, I think.
After all this time, how can we be sure Rasputin has the code?
I already stole it once. Used my last copy making that stealth drive you blew up. That, it was getting old anyway.
Much luck breaching Rasputin's security.
You got the same bypass frequency that got me inside.
He will protect his domain. That ain't Jersey Shore. Only that's the news. And these the same people supposedly telling us the truth. Limbo is a racist. Glenn Beck is a racist. Gaza Strip was getting by. Obama didn't say shit. That's why I ain't vote for. Next one, even part of the problem.
More interdimensional goo. Taking her here.
What? Not possible. We sealed the complex after the Omnigal breach.
Cade, look at this.
Oh, that does look bad. Okay, so if you see him, just shoot him. How did they even get in there?
The Taken are not bound by terrestrial constraints.
Yeah, I'll bet they'll be constrained by terrestrial bullets.
Ever the diplomat. Terrible singer. I know. I gotta stop. I cannot hold a pitch with a button.
You love McDonald's all day breakfast.
Yes, I don't even know.
You can't get all your favorites all day.
No.
Taken can track us so easily.
Oh,
Rex really does hate us.
info.
Which is exactly why we're here. We need those cloaking codes.
Scary Halloween party.
That was another dead ghost. So the song you just heard was Testify by Common. Very good. Good story. Like an episode of Longer. Common, I don't know if Common would appreciate that, so don't take that out. Probably not. Probably not. Really. The very intriguing.
I understand. I'm not sure if it can be modified to work on a Guardian.
Where do you think Blade Dancers got their cloaking ability?
If the Vanguard are satisfied, we can finally end this. Return to the moon.
steel, quote his soul. Would you turn my volume up in front of the cops? They crank it higher every time they told you to stop. And all I ask is that you don't get mad at me when you have to purchase Mad D batteries. Appreciate every mixtape your friends make. You never know, we come and go like on the interstate. I think I finally found a note to make you understand. If you can hit it, sing along and take me by the head. Just keep me stuck inside your head like you can't do. You know my heart's stereo, the only place for you.
We'll go decode those and then call it a night. Oh good, a political commercial. Nice.
Solely gun control.
Gun control. It will
turn well made. Kate Scouts have brought me a very lucky guardian.
It's a good thing nobody's sick of hearing those.
It's not gonna do a thing to prevent crime.
Question one is a bad idea.
And it would be a bad law for Nevada.
Stand with law enforcement and vote
no. Oh gosh, okay, I'm gonna do this now. I keep forgetting.
Open log.
That's my no. That's my heavy.
Updating schedules.
Oh well, I did that earlier. Should have had that on.
I had a rough day, but that's life. It happens. Woke up on a dark side of my mattress.
I guess I
forgot to set my clock. Overslept, almost lost the job. Been to top it off, I'm kind of hungry. Can't eat till I find my money. It's in my wallet, but my wallet
oh,
in
that
my
has
pocket.
Nice
can't remember the last time I saw it. And they don't want me in a bad mood. Afraid that it'll spread and everyone will catch an attitude. They got them all singing the same tune. Thinking
I'm
I should go start a
these.
Fire in the break room. Co-workers make me sick. And the manager really ain't shit. But I can't quit, so I'm hiding in the basement. Holding on to my face like fuck this place.
Alright, let me get...
Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. So I was trying to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's
yeah.
play.
Checking.
Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. So I was trying to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Hell no, I ain't going to school. The teacher's
Vex
a jerk, he must think I'm a fool. And all the kids mess with each other always, all day. Class warfare
checking.
Up and down the hallways. And if you ain't popular,
okay.
nobody exchange talks complete. To you unless they
all right, well,
you.
I think that will be it for tonight. It was a very productive day. Did well in the Iron Banner. Got the Nightfall and the Daily done. Very nice. Well, I would like to thank everyone for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Again, feel free to follow me on Twitter. You can follow me at Scott D. Anderson. Also, be sure to go check out rectifygaming.com for lots of great gaming news and all that jazz. They also have a Twitch channel, which is just Rectify Gaming. Lots of Halo on there. I've been playing Forza Horizon 3 recently, and also, of course, Destiny with the new Rise of Iron expansion. So be sure to do all that, and then check in next time, and I will see you then.
with an upset stomach. The overdraft notices just kept coming.